Bienvenidos a otro episodio de Aprende Español con Twitter. Hoy, todos los tweets dicen: De chico pensaba. When I was little, or as a kid, I used to think, or I thought. Y algunas palabras comunes son: pensaba, que era mejor y peor. Go ahead and figure out what the tweets say before I tell you, and pause the video if you need more time. De chico pensaba que la luna era queso. When I was little, I used to think that the moon was cheese. Notice here that la luna is the word for the moon, and it looks kind of like lunar, so it's pretty easy to remember. De chico pensaba que la vida era fácil. When I was little, I used to think that life was easy. Notice in English we say life was easy, while in Spanish we say la vida, the life. It might be more common to use the articles the, a, an, that is, el, la, los, las, in Spanish more than we would in English. De chico pensaba que si tenía cinco pesos era millonario. When I was little, I used to think that if I had 5 pesos, I was a millionaire. Notice here that they use C without an accent mark, and it's actually correct. It means if, whereas C with an accent mark means yes. Of course, they are both pronounced the same, but if you see them written, that's usually the general rule, although people don't always follow the accent marks on the internet. If you hear them, you just have to know because of the context. De chico pensaba. No pensaba. No me preocupaba. Era chiquita. Solo jugaba. When I was little, I used to think. I didn't used to think. I didn't used to worry. I was little. I only used to play. Notice that the BA or the ABA ending in the verbs gives the idea of past with used to do something or would do something. So you might say, I wouldn't think. I wouldn't worry. I was little. I would only play. In the idea of the past. And notice also, while chico and chica can mean boy and girl, they can also be used to refer to someone's size as little or small. So in this case, it says era chiquita. I was small. While ito and ita on the end of nouns can mean small or little, it doesn't always translate either, like here with chiquita. So it'd be like really small, or really, but she's just saying when she was little. De chico pensaba que ser más grande era mejor, pero en realidad es peor. When I was little, I used to think that to be bigger was better, but in reality, it is worse. Notice there's a spelling error here. Más should have an accent mark. Más without an accent mark means but. It's not really commonly used, but you might see it in poetry and songs. Más with an accent mark means more. Notice to say bigger, we'll say más grande, or more big. In English, we add ER to the end of the description usually, so faster, slower. So in Spanish, this is how we do that. We have to add más in front. But notice that mejor is better, and peor is worse. While we use más in front of most descriptions, these are the exceptions. So mejor and peor are considered better Spanish than más bueno, more good, or más malo, more bad, although you might still hear those from native speakers. De chico pensaba que una chica se quedaba embarazada cuando besaba a alguien. ¡Qué inocente era! When I was little, I used to think that a girl would get pregnant when she would kiss someone. How innocent I was! Here's a nice little word to learn. Embarazada, if you didn't know, means pregnant. It's not the word for embarrassed, although that might embarrass you if you use it the wrong way. Also notice that even though quedarse means to stay or to remain, se quedaba here might sound better as translated to he or she in this case, would get pregnant. Not really, she would stay pregnant or remain pregnant. If you're confused why there's an a in the phrase, besaba a alguien, she would kiss someone, When a person is the direct object of a verb, we need the a, whether it translates or not. And finally, there should be an accent mark over the e and k, because with a k plus description is like saying, oh, how something, how beautiful, how great, in this case, how innocent. De chico pensaba que en el televisor vivían personitas que eran las que hacían los programas. When I was little, I used to think that in the TV set lived little people that were the ones that made the programs. Notice that Q is an abbreviation for K, that. Also, again, we see ito and ita. It's often added to the end of things to give the idea of little or small. So, personitas here would be little people or small people. Also notice that all the verbs or actions here have an N at the end, because the N after an action or verb usually means they or you all do something. So vivían, they lived, eran, they were, hacían, they did, or they made. And there's some spelling errors here. Vivían should have an accent mark, and hacían should have an accent mark over the I's. De chico pensaba que en el pasado el mundo era en blanco y negro como en las pelis. When I was little, I used to think that in the past the world was in white and black like in the movies. Notice that while in English we say black and white, in Spanish the order is reversed. Blanco y negro, white and black. Also notice that pelis is an abbreviation for películas, movies. De chico pensaba que Hakuna Matata era la mejor frase del mundo. Ahora sé que es la mejor actitud. When I was little, I used to think that Hakuna Matata was the best phrase in the world. Now, I know that it's the best attitude. Notice that while mejor often means better, it could mean best when placed in the noun phrase with the, such as in the phrases la mejor frase, the best phrase, la mejor actitud, the best attitude. Y uno más. De chico pensaba que dormir la siesta era el peor castigo del mundo. Perdón, siesta, por no valorarte antes. Te amo. When I was little, I used to think that sleeping a nap was the worst punishment in the world. Sorry, nap, for not valuing you before. I love you. Notice in the phrase el peor castigo, the worst punishment, we see peor here, worse, meaning worst, because of the, that is, el, like we saw earlier with mejor. In the phrase del mundo, notice that de plus el shortens to del. Also, we'll say in Spanish, the worst punishment of the world, not in the world. And finally, notice the phrase te amo is a really romantic way of saying I love you. But it's backwards. It says you, I love. Well, that's it for this episode of Aprende Español con Twitter. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for updates on new video lessons. And if you want to start over in the series, click here. If you want to go to the previous episode, click here. Or if you want to go to the next episode, click here. Y escribe tu tweet favorito en la sección de comentarios. O escribe un comentario con De Chico Pensaba. Gracias por mirar y nos vemos.